could have events in the future where the power grid will go down and it's not in any reasonable time coming back on. For instance, if when the power grid went down, some of our large transformers were destroyed, damaged, beyond use. We don't make any of those in this country. They're made overseas, and you order one, and 18 months to 2 years later, they will deliver it. Our power grid is very vulnerable. It is very much on the edge. Our military knows that.
You know, one of the things I think of is in the event of a disaster, what do people do? They flock to the stores. They buy up all their staples and water. So your store will be empty faster than it's ever been empty before.
When this thing happens to this country, all financial support will be taken away from us. There'll be no financial support. We have to learn how to live without money. And the guy in the country is the one who's going to do this.
A rural area is not a fruitful area for terrorism. The terrorists are going to be looking for the biggest bang for their buck they can get, the highest yield of death. And that's exactly why they mention such things as malls and stadiums, and where there are going to be large concentrations of people.
So there are a number of events that could create a situation in the cities where civil unrest would be a very high probability. And I think that those who can and those who understand need to take advantage of the opportunity when these winds of strife are not blowing to move their families out. I'll tell you something else about this. It's just plain fun. When you're looking at the challenge of what do I have to do so that I'm independent of the system,
we need to get out.
A storm is coming, relentless in its fury. Are we prepared to meet it?
There was a very unusual event that happened. Television, telephone, radio, and this other unusual communication device I was able to see into many, many homes in the United States, these white boxes that were about this big that looked to be like televisions. And when I saw these, they were in nearly every single home in the U.S. And they would have words written across them, and occasionally it would almost look as though television was playing through them. All of those media devices were shut down for about a two-week period. I know now that what I was seeing was personal computers in people's homes. In 1980, I've done some studies, by the way, about all the things I saw to see if, in fact, I was hearing something from God, because I'm not about to go on national television or around the globe and share this if it's incorrect. I have a ministry of my own right now, and I don't feel like jeopardizing what the Lord has established for the past 17 years. In 1980 and 81, there was less than 0.5% of American homes that had a computer in it. All these things were shut down. One of the things that was happening during this hysteria was many, many people were asking, where did these people go? What happened? And all the globe saw this event, or they experienced it afterwards. What I saw in people was that literally nearly everyone I experienced had a great, great look of despair and hopelessness upon their face. Everywhere I went, there was hopelessness. Nobody seemed to be happy about living. You know, I've never experienced that. I've been to a lot of public places where people are bummed out, not happy, not doing well, but not the globe in masses. I don't know, maybe you've seen that. I haven't. So this hysteria brought a complete hopelessness and total perplexity to just about everyone. This shutdown alarmed all of the peoples, and it lasted for about 2 weeks. Can you imagine briefly tonight all of your communications, your telephone, computers, television, and radio being shut down for a two-week period of time? Can you imagine the hysteria? Can you imagine, you know, the inability for a supermarket to contact its suppliers to get more supplies or gasoline or transactions? It's amazing when you begin to see it kind of unfold, the depth. This lasted about 2 weeks. Again, I want to remind you, I was not a prophecy studier or expert at this time when this vision came to me. I began to walk the streets in shock at the current events. The events are difficult to describe because lawlessness and fear was permeating society completely. After about 2 weeks of time, television and radio began to be back up and running. However, it was completely different than what was previously being broadcast. The broadcasts were being bombarded nearly everywhere, and they were depicting a soon-to-come new government and leadership.